A shocking new poll shows that most of the UK would rather see Prince William become the King of England over Prince Charles. The Prince of Wales is next in line to inherit the crown but has struggled to boost his popularity over the years. The new poll proves that Charles has failed to win widespread support for his claim, but what are the chances that he abdicates in favor of his son? William wins the poll to be king. It is no secret that Prince Charles has struggled in the public relations department. A lot of his unpopularity stems from his affair with Camilla Parker Bowles and subsequent divorce from Princess Diana, who passed away a year after their split was finalized. Although Charles waited nearly a decade before marrying Bowles, their union did not help his public image. To be fair, Charles's popularity has increased in recent years, but a new poll suggests that he is still nowhere near as popular as his son, Prince William. The poll was conducted online by Express and featured over 4,000 voters. Of all the people who voted, over 60% thought that William should be king instead of Charles. The Prince of Wales only managed to attract 18% of the vote, far below what Prince William received. The other 20% of the vote went towards Prince Harry and William's children, Prince George, Princess Charlotte, and Prince Louis. Dozens of royal watchers also commented on the poll, many of them sharing negative thoughts about Charles taking the throne. A few fans also expressed their excitement about Kate Middleton being the next queen consort and thought she would do a great job in the role. The last two Charleses were not much good, one fan wrote, while another added, "I agree, he is a liberal lovey." Inside Prince William's obsession with motorcycles. Part of why William is so popular is his connection to the average person. Case in point is the Duke of Cambridge's obsession with motorcycles. In his book, William's Princess, The Love Story That Will Change the Royal Family Forever, author Robert Jobson claims that Charles struggled with keeping William from dangerous hobbies as a young man. Not one to shelter his children, Charles felt like it was okay to allow Prince William to explore whatever he wished, even if it put him in harm's way. This led to William's love for riding motorcycles, a hobby he keeps to this day. Earlier this year, William was spotted riding his sporty Ducati bike in London. As royal watchers may recall, he also rode his motorcycle on the eve of his wedding and, in 2008, ventured across South Africa on his bike alongside his brother, Prince Harry. Fortunately, William has toned things down since having children and does not ride nearly as often as he once did. Prince William, of course, is not the only one in the royal family with a love for motorcycles. King George VI also loved riding way back in the day and was known to drive his motorcycle to class at Cambridge. A look at the royal line of succession. As it currently stands, Charles will get the throne once Queen Elizabeth steps down or passes away. With Elizabeth in her 90s, the idea of abdicating in favor of Charles is becoming more and more likely. After Charles, Prince William is next in line, following all three of his children. Up next is Prince Harry and then his firstborn son, Archie. Prior to the birth of William's children, Harry was third in line to the crown. The line of succession, of course, will change once Prince George and his siblings grow up and have children of their own. Despite all the speculation, Charles has shown zero signs of abdicating once Elizabeth's reign is over. Charles has now waited longer than anyone in the history of the monarchy to take the throne and will likely step up to the plate when the time is right. A lot could change until that happens, so there is always the chance that William inherits the crown next. The royal family has not commented on the recent poll concerning if Prince William is better suited to be the next King of England. Whenever we see Prince Charles, he looks rather kingly. Over the years, we've watched the future King of England go from incredibly stoic member of the royal family to fun-loving, jovial grandfather. Oh, and another emotion we've seen from old Chuck. Irritation with his sons, Prince William and Prince Harry. For the most part, it seems like Prince Charles has a very close relationship with his two boys. But hey, kids can get annoying sometimes, right? In the past few years, there have more than a few rumblings that things between Prince William and Prince Harry weren't so good, so, Is that contributing to Prince Charles's frustration with his sons? Perhaps. But it could also just be good old-fashioned parent-child disagreements. Happens to the best of them. While there's no way the future King of England would come out and say his kids were annoying him, we know that look when we see it, even when it's on a member of the royal family who plays it close to the vest most of the time. From furrowed brows to simply looking the other way, here are 20 times we're pretty confident Prince Charles looked annoyed with his boys, Prince William and Prince Harry. Queen Elizabeth has endured a lot of hardships over the past 65 years as the Queen of England, but it was her children and grandchildren that reportedly gave her the most heartbreak. In her own words, one of the worst years of Elizabeth's long reign was 1992, a year that witnessed three of Her Majesty's children ending their marriages. While watching three of her children get divorced was hard enough, Elizabeth's heartbreak did not end there. Here's an inside look at Queen Elizabeth's heartbreak by both her children and grandchildren. Her Majesty recalls a heartbreaking year. Elizabeth and her husband of 70 years, Prince Philip, have four children, Prince Charles, Princess Anne, Prince Andrew, and Prince Edward. While Elizabeth and Philip's marriage has remained strong for decades, three of her kids experienced heartbreaking divorces in 1992. In a speech in November of that same year, Queen Elizabeth gave a speech in which she called 1992 an annus horribilis, or a horrible year. The royal family dealt with a number of different scandals that year, but Elizabeth's comments were mostly due to the family's relationship woes. 1992 is not a year on which I shall look back with undiluted pleasure, Elizabeth shared. In the words of one of my more sympathetic correspondents, it has turned out to be an annus horribilis. According to Express, Prince Andrew was the first of Queen Elizabeth's children to go through a divorce. Andrew split from his wife, Sarah Ferguson, in the early spring of 1992. A month after Andrew's shocking breakup, Princess Anne announced that she was getting a divorce from Mark Phillips. As if that was not bad enough, the royal family experienced one of its biggest scandals of the past century when Princess Diana went public with Charles's affair with Camilla Parker Bowles, a move that effectively ended their relationship and led to their official divorce a few years later. Charles and Diana started living separate lives in December of 1992, a month following Elizabeth's heartbreaking speech. Inside Queen Elizabeth's devastating year. Apart from the divorces, Elizabeth had to deal with a number of other mishaps in 1992. A fire broke out in Windsor Castle in November of that year, doing extensive damage to the property. Elizabeth also learned about the passing of her nephew, Prince Albrecht. The death came on the same day that Princess Anne announced her divorce, dealing a double blow to the royal family. All of these things came after Prince Andrew announced his divorce, which only made things even more difficult to handle for Queen Elizabeth. To make things even more complicated, Ferguson was caught laying out in the sun, topless, in August with her good friend, John Bryan. Images of the outing were later published in magazines around the world. The royal family also had to deal with leaked tapes that recorded conversations between Diana and James Gilbey. During one of their chats, Gilbey referred to Diana by a nickname, Squidgy. The tapes confirmed the rumors that Charles's marriage was on the rocks. While all of these things made 1992 a difficult year, it was the divorces that really put Elizabeth over the edge. Prince William once caused Elizabeth heartbreak too. Elizabeth has been an amazing mentor to her oldest grandson, Prince William, and has been preparing him for the throne for years. But there was once a time when Elizabeth's relationship with William was strained. Following Charles and Diana's divorce, Elizabeth stepped in to help instruct William on what it takes to be at the head of the monarchy. At the time, William had just started school at Eton, and inside sources claim that Queen Elizabeth was worried that William could not take the pressures of being king. William is currently second in line to the throne, following his father. Elizabeth and William started going on lunch dates together, where Her Majesty took the opportunity to teach her grandson lessons. The pair grew closer by spending time together and still share a tight bond to this day. Although Elizabeth experienced a lot of heartbreak with her own children, William's marriage to Kate Middleton is stronger than ever, as is Prince Harry's union to Meghan Markle. Queen Elizabeth has not commented on the latest rumors surrounding her children's divorces and scandals over the years.